1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. On the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again.
Say hi to everybody, Petey. Well, I received a nice package today from across the ocean. Armando Lani sent me this nice gift, a couple of tools for my collection. He knows I like small tools, and this is one of the smallest ones I had so far. It was actually a toy, but I restored it to look like a real tool, but he came up with something even smaller. Here's a nice little wrench that I think he restored and put a video on his site once about this. Put a nice red coloring in it. It actually works. Nice little tool, but it's considerably smaller than the one I already have. And I'm going to enjoy having this one. Really nice of him to send this to me. In addition to that, an actual Singer screwdriver. Singer made sewing machines, and this is a little screwdriver they'll ship with the sewing machine, and that's a really small, tiny little wrench. I don't have anything, screwdriver, don't have anything that small. So, that gets me to thinking it's time to do a small tool video. I'm fascinated by the tiny tools, and I got quite a collection. After I get these cleaned up and added to the collection, I'll show the whole collection. But here's something I bought on eBay. Paid, I think, around $14 for all of them, which wasn't bad. Some of them are nice, some of them are not much. Next is a pair of channel lock wrenches. It's just channel lock, Meadville, Pennsylvania. Got a patent number on it. It was patented in 1934. So, just a little channel lock style. You can slide to change the grip size. Next would be a punch. I thought at first it was a scribe, but seems to be a punch. However, I'm looking it over here. Yeah. Maybe at one time this came with a lot of attachments because this one comes out. So I guess maybe it did at one time. Made by General Hardware Manufacturing. Actually called a pick punch. So I guess the other item was a pick or a scribe, a sharp point. Next is a nice 4-inch crescent wrench. I have several of these 4-inch adjustable wrenches. This one is in working condition, unlike some of them. Of course, dirty and patina. Crescent Tool Company, Jamestown, New York. Like I said, I've got quite a collection of those wrenches. I didn't have a crescent one, which is, I believe, the first brand that was made on an adjustable wrench like this, but it may not be. Everyone calls them crescent wrenches. Next would be a wire cutter. Little wire cutter, and this is actually a Red Devil brand. So all you familiar with Red Devil tools, it's got a nice handle on here. Will need to be cleaned up. Next is called Vacuum Grip Pliers. And from Newport, Pennsylvania. You can see the little jaws. And a file made by Heller, Heller USA. A little small file, nothing special there. This nice item is a Stanley ratcheting screwdriver. This was patented in 1956. And how it works is, you turn your screw and then it ratchets back. I don't know if you can hear the ratcheting. And then you can flip it over and you've got a large and a small slotted screwdriver head. Same thing here, ratcheting, and then it's ratcheting, and if you need to reverse it, it's got a little switch that reverses it. So it will reverse both sides. Made by Stanley. Oh, the Yankee, Yankee. Yankee. Like I said, patented in 1956. Last item I got in the batch was just a know-nothing screwdriver. No name, no nothing, just a little screwdriver to throw in the toolbox. So we'll get these cleaned up and see what they look like cleaned up. Be back to show you. And here's some tiny tools arrived just in time to add to my haul I just received. I've got several of these wrenches. I just like them, a little 4-inch. Adjustable wrench. This one is rusty here, all in the screw, the turning mechanism. And but other than that, it's in pretty good shape. J.H. Williams Company. I don't have one of those. That's why I got this one. The head of it's in pretty good shape. Scratched, but still polished and looking pretty good. This second one I got was a Utica. So that's really a different one. I don't have a Utica adjustable wrench. I've got a couple of pliers and cutters, but not an adjustable wrench. And of course, this one's in the 4-inch variety. Bad rusty stain on it here, and a lot of patina on this. We'll have to clean that up. But I'll add that to my tool haul restoration, and then we'll conclude the video with a review of my tiny tool collection. And now for the reveal of the restored wrenches, the nice channel locks, the pick punch, a nice crescent wrench. It's too bad on this wrench. The one who owned it punched it 3 times here and put 3 marks over here. I guess there's a means of identifying it as his tool, and they were pretty deep, so I couldn't really get them out. So sorry that happened to that wrench, because I am collecting that style of wrench. Of course, here's the Red Devil wire cutters. And the gripper pliers with the nice, well-defined jaws. And here's a cleanup on the Heller file. The nice one of the bunch, the Stanley ratcheting angle screwdriver. It's reversible with the switch. Is all cleaned up, looking nice. And of course, the little nothing screwdriver. Didn't take much just to clean that a little bit. Another one that I've been collecting are these 4-inch adjustable wrenches, the J.H. Williams. Did the nice red color on it. That one turned out very nice. Nice improvement. And lastly, again, another very nice one, this Utica adjustable wrench. All of these clean nicely and ready to go with my small tool collection. Now, I was going to bring all my tiny tools. And I got to counting. I've got like over 50. So, and really, I've got a grouping here of 4-inch and under. Then I have another group that are 5 and 6-inch wrenches. So for just today, I'm going to go over the tiny ones, the 4-inch and under tools. I'll be bringing the rest of the collection out. Okay, here's my grouping of tiny tools, 4 inches and under. The 3 inches I showed you initially, plus the other ones I had in my collection that I really like. This Craftsman, of course, put the nice Craftsman red color in here. A diamond wrench, one of my favorites. The people I think that make some of the nice ones, and they really do a lot of their name on there very nicely, so it's very readable. And that was the crescent wrench that I bought. Got another one. Oh yeah, Proto Los Angeles, it says on it. Very well made, very nice wrench. So I've got 6 of these adjustable wrenches in my collection now. I'm looking for more to get a little variety of brands. There were a lot of brands made. And of course, the little screwdriver sent to me by Armando Lani, along with the tiny little wrench. And you can see, compared to the 4-inch wrench, really small. Here's an interesting wrench that was actually cataloged in the Sears catalog. It's a Craftsman wrench. It's a 1364 size. It's got the part number 49322, the catalog number. So it was a wrench you could buy from the store, and it would warranty just like the big wrenches. It just went along with their collection of wrenches. This little grouping in here were the basically toys. The brand was Marks. And when I bought them, they were all just a bright, shiny, terrible looking finish, I guess. A heavy zinc plate or some type of cadmium or something they put on it. But it made them look even cheaper. So I took all of these tools, took all the finish off, and then finished them with the super glue. And it really made them look very real, like the big tools. These are all made out of a pot metal, you know, not steel, but they're marked with the sizes, 3/8, 11/32, and look like the real thing. So they'll go in my miniatures collection. This one I made to look like the Rigid Rich, by giving it the same color. Finished all the area up here to where it looked like their wrenches. And of course, a nice, they're all working tools, little slip joint pliers. Again, finished the same way. Showed you these wrenches earlier in the lot of tools I bought. Here's another one I've had, but there's no name on it. There was something on here at one time, but it's gone now. I can't even tell what the brand is. This one's strange. It says Simcoe US, but then underneath, made in Italy. So, Simcoe US, made in Italy. Little flat nose pliers. Nice. I've used these on occasion for some small jobs. This is a nice wrench that was sent to me by Ben Surfey. You'll know him as the Tool Addict. A King Dick wrench, one I didn't have. I was real excited to get. And this one's got some heavy pitting on it. I didn't grind it down and smooth it out. Because I will like the original finish on here. It looks natural. I may someday grind it down and then try to refinish it with the super glue. But I didn't want to damage the wrench. I wanted to keep it in original condition. Another nice bicycle wrench. Couldn't read the name. Billings and Spencer. It's on here, very small. My eyes are getting a little worse all along here, so I'm having some troubles with some things without my magnifying lens. And of course, here's a great little wrench also from England, Birmingham, made in Birmingham, England, a Grider Joseph Lucas wrench. Grider wrench. It's got their nice little logo here. And again, in the 4-inch category. From Germany, a copy of the Perfect Handle Wrench, and it's a beautiful little tool. Well made. They did a nice job on it. So that fits the category. Another wrench that I must believe was a sewing machine wrench. They made a lot of them in this style. I'm not sure. It's a little better made than a lot of them, so it may be something else, just the way it was designed. It's got some names on here, but I try to look them up. It doesn't tell me anything. I can't find anything. I looked and looked, tried to find a company. Nice snap-on 4-inch, quarter-inch drive socket. Beautiful little tool. And I've got one of the sockets to go with it, too. And that's the only snap-on tool I own. A lot of people have got their whole tool set snap-on. And lastly, the little Yankee Stanley wrench that I bought in that last collection, ratcheting angled wrench. So that's my collection. Oh, I've got one last thing. Got to bring that out. Interesting, I'm putting this with the tools. This is a clamp. But most clamps that are this size are just stamped out of a piece of flat metal and formed a little and something put in there. This is a Vulcan. And it's, as you can see, it's thick, formed like the big ones, heavy like the big ones. Got the nice butterfly wing on it, wing nut on it. So that's just a nice little tool. It belongs with a small tool collection rather than with the clamps. About 3 inches long. So there's a little tour and update. It's probably twice the size I had earlier when I showed it of small tools. And I got about another 20 or so to go in the 5-inch to 6-inch range. I've got some nice tools in there. I'll save that for another video so this doesn't rattle on forever. Thanks for watching my video today.